Happee Knitters, and welcome back to our channel. So today is Saturday, May. We don't even know what date is.
27th.
The 27th. And we are coming to you from right outside of Dallas, Texas. And my name is Yolanda.
I'm Gordon.
And I have a 15-year-old son named Dante and a 3-year-old daughter named Alexis. And I have a husband named Steven. And we just celebrated our 21st anniversary on May the 25th. Yay!
I didn't know that. Well, oh, that's why y'all guys went out to eat.
Yes.
That makes sense.
Yes. So anyway, so we are so excited to be back podcasting today. It's been 3 weeks since our last podcast, and I just want to welcome everybody who is a returning viewer. If you are new to our podcast, welcome as well. Please sit down, have a drink, relax, and let's get started. So, Jordan, what episode is this?
Welcome back to episode 9.
Yay, we are in episode 9. How about that? So this episode is probably not going to be as long as some of our other episodes because, to be honest, in 3 weeks, I didn't get a whole lot done, but I did get some knitting done. And I don't know, it just seems like having a full-time job and running a household, and you ladies and even you guys know what it's like. So when you get home, sometimes knitting is not in the cards for us, but you know, we do what we do, right? So summer is fastly approaching, and Jordan and Dante are out of school.
Yeah, 3 more days.
You have 3 more days after Memorial Day. So Monday, of course, is Memorial Day in the U.S. So happy Memorial Day to you guys and all the veterans out there. So let's go ahead, I guess, and get started on this podcast.
In my last 3 days, they're all testing.
But think about it. You get to get out for the whole summer. Us working folks, we don't get that kind of a break. Unless you're a teacher, but you teachers deserve it more so than anybody, because if you got to teach these kids, God bless you. That's all I have to say is God bless you. Okay, so let's get started with, real quick. So I'm on social media as Happee Knits everywhere, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I have a Ravelry group called Happee Knits, so you guys head over there and join in, introduce yourselves, and yeah, I would love to read what's going on with you guys right now. So we're gonna start with
FOs.
Finished objects, FOs. I actually have two.
Oh, you printed it out this time.
If you follow me on Instagram, you saw that I had started another pair of socks for Alexis. I'm starting to try to use up some of my yarn that I have knit other socks with. And since she has small feet, I thought that was a great idea, is to just knit socks for her and kind of use up some of that scrap yarn. So I had some Knit Picks Felici left over from, it was probably a couple of years ago, come to think of it. And it was living in my Ziploc bag. I'm going to tell you, so if you go back to some of my earlier episodes on storage organization, I know that all of us knitters, we love our project bags, right? And I'm no different. But I used to, and I still do, use these cheapy Ziploc bags because,
cheapy.
Hey, let's face it, if you have a lot of projects, this is such an easy and inexpensive way to store your projects if you don't have the financial means to buy project bags or a bunch of project bags. These work just as well, and I just want to tell you guys that I still use these bags. I don't show them on the podcast. I haven't shown them on the podcast, but yes, I still use them. So anyways, her socks were in this bag, and I blocked them last night, so they're still just a little bit damp, but these are her finished socks.
You washed them.
I soaked them in eucalyptus. Is that how you say it? Yeah, eucalyptus. And
that greenish bottle thing.
They smell so good. Oh, they smell so good. So yeah, so I have completed another pair of socks for her. And this is in the colorway Sorbet. So it's kind of a, you know, so
sorbet.
I guess, yeah, Sorbet.
Nice.
And I will tell you, on these socks, if you follow Very Pink Knits on YouTube, she had an alternate way to do the KFB. So you guys know that I'm a huge fan of the fleegle heel. And on my fleegle heels, I usually do a make one left and a make one right for the back of the heel on my socks. And so I said, you know what, since her socks are small, I said, this is, and it's somewhat of a new technique, I thought I would try those on her socks. Well, it was a little bit of a fail, because how you do the alternate KFB is you don't knit the stitch off, you just slip the stitch off. And it really does not work when you are changing colors. And I really didn't think about that until after I had done it a couple of times. And I don't know if you can see this, but there is a little bit of the
thingy.
A little bit of where the, yeah, where the stitch was put up.
It's a typo.
Oh, let's see. Yeah, right there. And after that, I decided, you know what? Let me go back to the make one right and the make one left. So I did that just because, like I said, it left a little bit of a, I guess you kind of call it a color jog. And I wasn't sure when it got to the rest of the color changes if that was going to happen again. But I did like the alternate KFB. So if you guys have not seen that video, I mean, the KFB is fairly simple. You don't knit yet. The KFB is a fairly simple increase, but the alternate is even easier. So anyway, I knit these. She wears a size 10 to 11. So I cast on 48 stitches for these. I did the Turkish cast on for the toe and increased, and then did the fleagle heel, and I did 2x2 ribbing, which I think I did eight rounds of ribbing for her, because these are shorty socks. Even though on the camera they look fairly long, they're not. So anyway, one down, and I still have enough yarn to probably do baby socks, or I could possibly do another pair of socks for my niece. So we'll see.
Baby socks.
Or I can make some scrappy socks, which I've been kind of dying.
Wait, how many socks is that now?
Out of this one skein?
Oh, no, skein? I'm talking about in total for our 12 pair of socks goal.
I think we were up to 7 or 8. I think. And you guys, that's a real big deal for me, because that's a goal that I had set in January, was to knit 12 pairs of socks, and I'm totally on track to blow past that. So yeah, I really am happy about that. So in the last episode, I talked to you guys about my expensive signature needles and how I was not happy with the cord. So I had a viewer to let me know that I could soak these and possibly relax the cord a little bit. And I did. I don't know if you can see it. However, I wasn't sure how long to soak them or how hot to get the water, but I did soak them and it did uncurl somewhat. But I will tell you, I'm still not a fan of the cord. I'm just not. And like I said, it's a disappointment because, and this is strictly my opinion, it's a disappointment for me for the price that you pay for these needles. But like I said before, these points, oh my God, they are the best, let me tell you. So I will continue, of course, to knit with these. I'm not crazy about the cord, but I might try to relax, put them in the water one more time to see if I can just get it to relax a little bit more. But yeah, the points on these signature needles, they are unbeatable.
Believable.
So that's my final review on the signature needles.
Next
up is, I wanted to get back to my donation knitting. I'm trying to knit some items for donation towards it.
What?
Did you just yawn?
No.
Oh, did you open your mouth?
Yeah.
Cover.
I was excited because I know that we were gonna go to this.
Cover. So anyway, oh, you were excited. I thought you were, but your mouth was open. Anyway, we're having coffee this afternoon. It is not morning here in Texas. We've blown past that.
It is.
Alexis is asleep right now, so this was the perfect time
to get in
podcasting mode. But I was feeling a little draggy, so I said a little coffee pick-me-up would work. And what's this, Jordan, that we're drinking? What's the brand? I mean, what's the name of it? The flavor.
Wait, did we get the same kind?
Yeah.
Vanilla caramel.
Yeah, vanilla caramel latte. That's, oh, so good. So, anyway, so, yeah, I wanted to get back to my donation knitting. I've only knitted one thing that I'm donating, and you guys, if you guys remember that from one of my other previous podcasts.
Was it like the tiny blue
baby hat? Yeah, it was a tiny blue baby hat, the white and, the white and blue one. I'll make sure my cord is on. And so, so I thought about it. I said, you know what? I've got some bulky yarn, and I used to love to make bulky hats because they go so fast. So I decided to whip out a bulky hat. And ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce you to Sasha.
Sasha
has been in the family for
a long time,
probably at least 6 years. Sasha has been with us.
Personally, I was never a fan of her when I was little, because she stayed in a dark closet and it scared me.
Yeah, Sasha used to be scary to the boys. Especially this one. At night when he would come out and she would be sitting on the desk. She did look a little creepy. She did.
She doesn't blink.
But look at her. Like, but look at her. She is fierce. Fierce. Anyway, back to the knitting. So this is just a basic hat pattern that I found off of Ravelry. And guys, I gotta tell you, I tried to refine this this pattern and I cannot find it for some reason. I even looked through my browsing history. I didn't save it to my my library. It was just something that I found that was super quick and it was a super easy pattern. So I'm gonna see if I can find it and put it in the notes. But yeah, I didn't have success before the podcast. But anyway, so this is just loops and thread, cozy wool in the colorway Merlot. I think it's 100%, is it? No, it's 50% acrylic, I think, and 50% wool. Yeah. And so I just added a cute little pom-pom on the top just to add a little bit of depth. And I will tell you, the pattern that I used, I was not a fan of the decreases because it decreased a lot faster at the end than I'm normally used to, because I'm normally used to the decrease one row, knit an even row, etc. And it did start out like that, and then at the end it just did knit twos all the way around and then knit twos again to kind of shorten it. And for me, I actually have a little bit of a, I have a big head.
You got a tiny piece of yarn into my coffee.
Okay. It's just a fluff from the ponytail. So anyway, I have a big head.
Pom-pom.
What did I just say?
Ponytail.
Sorry. Pom-pom. So I have a big head, and this hat did not go down far enough for me. But if you have a smaller head, it would fit you just fine. So yeah, so I'm happy with this for a donation. And like I said, it was very easy, simple, very fast knit. I think I knit these on size 15s, and I literally had it done in a couple hours. That's how fast it was, because bulky yarn goes so quick. So anyway, so I've got something for another donation. I think I have a couple more skeins of that. So I'll probably do a few more hats and maybe a little bit of color work just to change it up just a little bit to make it interesting. But yeah, then that goes into my donation stack. So I'm pretty happy with sit up, Jordan.
Sleepy.
For somebody that does not hold down a 9-to-5 job, and I don't know how your kids are, but why are they always sleepy? Why? They don't work.
We go to school.
Yeah.
That takes the same amount of energy out of you.
I can't hear you. What?
Going to school takes the same amount of energy out of you.
Okay, y'all, that work, is that true? No.
Yes.
No. So anyway, so now let's go on to whips.
Wipes.
I have two, but I'm only going to show you one because the other one is that Camp Wilkerson shawl that you guys have seen in 50 million episodes of this podcast.
It's only been nine.
I am not showing that shawl again until I am finished. And I think I kind of tend to want to knit socks and then I knit that hat. It's almost like I'm sabotaging myself not to finish that shawl. And I love it. I love it. I just need to just sit down and do it.
And
so
the poor other wrap.
Oh, that other wrap.
That never got touched.
He's talking about that I want my wrap. That I want that wrap pattern. It's in timeout. It's going to get done. It's just, you know, it's going to get
the bottom of the train.
It's going to get done on my time.
It managed to make its way back to the pick list, basically.
Yes. By the time you guys see that wrap again, it will be done. The Camp Wilkerson wrap will be done. And I will be proud to show it to you guys. But I know I don't want you guys to get sick of seeing it. So I'm not going to show it today.
And I'll be 15.
You won't be 15. Okay, so last week I showed you my sister's socks. I did make some progress on it from the last time you saw it. I switched to making Alexis a pair of socks, so this one didn't get her socks didn't get a whole lot of love this go round. But this again, this again is the turtle purl yarn from. She has a shop on Etsy, and this is in her colorway City Girl. So anyway, my sister picked this particular colorway or this yarn for her socks, and I'm loving it. So it is a very nice and quick and fast knit. And these are being knit on my higher sharps, which I love. Let me change my lighting a little bit.
Blue Hiya, reddish Yadu, and greenish Signature Arts.
Very good. So anyway, so yeah, so they're coming along. They will be done before the next podcast because I'm at the point where I'm increasing on the heel. So yeah, they're going to be my basic fleegle heel again. And yeah, I think she's going to really, really enjoy those. And they are, of course, in my utterly adorable socks bag that you have guys seen, that you've seen over and over again. I love her bags because they're two at a time bags.
I've seen this bag for a long time.
Yes, it just keeps coming back.
Oh, no. Why is everything falling into my coffee?
You need to move it out of the way. So that is the whip that I'm working on that I want to show you. Now, in the pick section, which stands for
Project and Cue.
Projects and Cue. We still have the same ones that we had last week because I have not progressed any past what you guys saw. So I did point out to you that I wanted to knit this blanket for Alexis. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, the Chevron. It's a baby blanket, but I think I'm going to make it a little bit bigger for her. The only problem is choosing the colors, right? Sometimes it's hard to pick colors. I don't want it to be a traditional baby colors because, of course, she's not a baby. But yeah, I'm trying to think what that is going to look like. So I'm going to get some Knit Picks yarn and yeah, I just need to find out what color I'm going to do. And then the other pick is the pair of socks for my sister that I showed you guys the last time. I had them already. No, I didn't have them casted on. I had them already. balled them up.
In their little case.
Is it? It's trying to find you. So, yeah, so that's the color. And it is, which I just love it because it's such nice, pretty colors. It is the,
it found me again.
It did. It is the Lang Jawoll in the colorway 132.0457. So I've
that
used
that means multicolor.
No, it doesn't. I've used this yarn before, and I actually am loving. I love it. So, and these are going to be knit on my Chowgu size 1.
The red ones.
2.25. I knit all my socks on 2.25. Needles, and of course two at a time with a 40-inch cord. So yeah, so I need to, I don't know why I didn't cast those on. I could have at least gotten the toes started, but
with an idea.
What?
The next sock needles that you need to get need to be yellow in a different brand.
They don't have yellow in a different brand.
How you know?
I consider myself to be pretty up on sock needles.
How about purple, orange? Anything besides those three colors.
Okay. Yeah. So anyway, so those are the picks that I have. Like I said, they are the same from the last podcast. So let's move on to acquisitions. So I want to first talk about an app that I found, and you guys may already know about it. I found it on my Facebook group, Addicted to Sock Knitting. If you are not a member of that group, I suggest that you
join
because if you love socks like I love socks, it is such an inspirational Facebook group because it's all about sock knitting. But anyway, and I'm not sure this was on that group or one of my other knitting groups, but there is a free app called the
Bee Count.
B-E-E count.
Bumblebee.
And I will try and put it up on the screen. Let's see if I can find it for you. Let's see. Can you see? Show it to him, Jordan.
It's that tiny one.
And I'll put a picture up on the screen for you. And I have an Android phone, so I'm not sure if it's available with Apple, but I would think it would be. And what is so cool about this app is that you can have multiple projects on this app.
Oh, and it keeps count.
Let me see if it will focus.
I just realized how useful the app is.
Is it gonna focus, Jordan? Maybe not.
No.
Let me see.
Electronics don't focus very well.
They don't focus very well. Sorry about that. But I will try and put some screenshots in here for you so that you can see. But what is cool about this app is you can have multiple projects for this app, and it's all free. So you don't need to buy countless different row counters when you've got this app, because you can put down that I'm doing socks. Jordan, stop. He's messing with his fidget spinner.
I just want to spin it.
But we're not, but I can hear it. It's going to be a long weekend, guys. Long weekend. So anyway, back to what I was saying. So you can have multiple projects. You can have as many as you want. But here's what I love about this. Like, I've got Alexis's socks that, I know you guys can't see this, but I have Alexis's socks that I did, and if I tap onto her socks, I can have as many different features on here as I want. Like the first one I have is when I was doing the count for her toe increases. The second one was for the leg, and the last one was counting rows for the ribbing. And you literally could have multiple row counters for one project, which I think is
multiple projects.
So I totally need, so if you guys do not have this app or you need some row counters, I highly recommend this Bee Count. I really, really do, because it has been a lifesaver for me. I just grab my phone and I just add in what I need to add in, click the plus button to increase the count. If I mess up, I can decrease it. And like I said, wonderful app. So if you need to get another row counter, or this is definitely the app for you.
This is non-advertisement.
Yes, it's non-advertisement. If I were ever sponsoring a product, I would totally let you guys know, because I feel like, you know, it all needs to be transparent. But that is not a sponsor. That is something that I found that I want to pass on to you guys, because I think it's such an awesome, awesome app. Okay, so next, and I'm gonna have to put up a picture on this one too, because it is in this box that I just got from Amazon. I just bought the Stanwood Needle Craft Jumbo Ball Winder.
Oh, you got a new ball winder?
I got a new ball winder.
Oh, so this can go in the trash.
No, it cannot. Oh. This is what it looks like, right? And I'll show you, I'll throw up a picture so you can see it on the screen. But I bought the ball winder because this is the one that I have currently. There's absolutely nothing wrong with it. It does a very, very good job. However, when I am winding, or Jordan, he does most of it for me. When I'm winding the skeins of sock yarn into one, this really does not cake it up very well, because I don't think it's meant for that amount of yarn. And Jordan knows that. And so I decided to grab the jumbo winder to help out with that. I'm still gonna use this for smaller skeins, but and this one was not that expensive. I think it was maybe $60-something
hey.
On. Huh?
That is expensive.
Relative, I think I paid $20 or $30 for this.
That's still expensive.
But that is a very good quality ball winder.
Well, I haven't used it yet. We will find out.
He can give you a review in the next podcast. But yeah, but I think it's a very, very good value for your money. But you know, different strokes for different folks, right? But anyway, so I bought that. I'm very excited to use it. I'll have to put it together and let you guys know what I think about it. But the reviews have been very good, and I know several people that use that particular ball winder, and they've had no issues with it. So yeah, I'm pretty excited about that.
This also isn't an advertisement.
It is also not an advertisement. I just told them that if I were sponsored, I would tell them. Anyway, so let me look at my notes, because he's getting me off my track once again.
That's
my goal. Okay, so I went to the mailbox this morning.
You did?
I did.
You went without me.
I went without you. And I was very happy to find something in my mailbox.
Happy mail, happy mail.
It's happy mail. Anytime you get yarn, it's happy. It makes you so, so happy.
And it's part of our channel name.
Happy. I want you guys to cast your eyes on this. Look at this. This is by Mitchell's Creations, and she is on Etsy, and that is her card. And she included with this skein of yarn a Florida leaf, because she's from Louisiana. And this beautiful, magnificent, just look at that. It is on her, let me see if I can say this right, Lagniappe sock base. It's a 4-ply fingering weight, 75% superwash merino.
German.
I think it's French. It's French. Lagniappe, 25% nylon, 463 yards, 100. Camera stopped because we were at 30 minutes, so I'm not sure where I was, but this is her her card. I'm sorry. Let's see. Is it going to show? Hold on, just a second. Yes, I think that is pronounced, uh-oh.
Lagniappe.
Because I had to look it up. Lagniappe, because the G is silent. Anyway, like I said, it's in her colorway, Chameleon.
Chameleon.
So beautiful. You guys know how much I love color. So check out her Etsy shop. I'll put the information below on the screen for you guys to check that out. But yes, so very happy. Okay. It's Lang. It's spelled L-A-G-N-A. I've already looked it up. Okay. So while he is checking out the pronunciation, which I have already told him, I want to introduce, so summer is around the corner here in the United States, and I am ready to do another cowl. The last one I did was the Luck of the Irish cowl. Lagniappe. That's what I said, I think. Or maybe I didn't.
It's a noun.
Lagniappe.
Oh, it's from... Yeah, I'm gonna say French. France.
Okay. Can we get back to... Can we get back to where we are?
Yes, we can.
Thank you. So, what I was talking about before I was interrupted
nicely
is I want to do another cowl. It's been a while since we've done one, and so Jordan came up with one. We're going to do a summer cowl. It is going to be called, you don't remember?
Some Like It Hot cowl.
Some Like It Hot. We want you guys to knit something that represents summer to you. Right. Whether it be a color that has inspired you, whether it's a story behind what you're knitting, whatever the reason that it reminds you of summer, that's going to be allowed in this cowl. It could be any knit, or if you're a crocheter, any crocheted item. It just has to have 50
grams of mass.
Yarn.
Mass. Is it mass or weight? Because grams is used for mass. I'm still hooked on science. We were doing our review yesterday.
Yeah. You knitters and crocheters know what I mean when I say 50 grams. Anyway, Some Like It Hot cowl. It just needs to represent summer. I'm going to have a thread open in the Ravelry group for you guys to post your, we're gonna have a thread for discussion, and then we're gonna have a finished objects thread where you can just pop in your final project, and let me know why it represents summer to you. So that one will not have any chatter, but the chatter thread, we can discuss and do whatever we want to in that thread. And I am so excited to see what you guys are going to be making. That cowl is going to run through the end of July, July 31st. So I want to give you time. This is going to be a relaxing cowl, because I know lots of people are going on vacation. They've got their kids out of school. So you might not have as much knitting time maybe as you used to. So we're going to stretch this out for a whole 2 months. Just so, like I said, I want it to be relaxing. And
I don't have a hat for this.
Hmm?
I don't have a hat for that.
What?
I don't have a hat for that.
For what?
I did for the Lottie cow. Or the Lucky the Irish cow. I had my little Irish hat. Now I don't have a hat for this cow.
Sometimes, guys, I don't understand what he's talking about. He just randomly just interjects conversation at any point in this podcast. But if you've been watching a long time, you already know that. So I'm trying.
I can't be in frame.
Okay. So, once again, Some Like It Hot, Summer Cowl, knit anything you like, as long as it's 50 grams. We're going to use the hashtag SLITHKAL.
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 Just like the Lottie.
Slithkal. So I hope you guys join us in that that Cal. I want, like I said, I want it to be fun. Of course, you can double dip if you've got projects that you're working on or about to start working on, because it needs to be cast on from the day of this airing until the end of July 31st. If you want to double dip, triple dip, it's fine. Like I said, only thing that I ask is that you explain why it represents summer to you, and we're good. So with that being in mind, I received another item in the mail from the lovely Madeline of the Knitting Square House podcast on YouTube. She is such a sweet person. So if you have not seen her podcast, head over there and check her out. She doesn't have a whole lot of podcasts up, but what she does have is great quality. And like I said, such a sweet person. So she has donated a prize to the podcast. And you guys, look at what it is. It is Q Loco yarn in the Lux sock base. It is 70-20-10 superwash merino, silk, and cashmere. When I tell you, this is
soft like a baby.
Soft like a baby. You laugh, but that is so true. It is in the colorway Icicle. It's such a pretty, it's actually been blown out in the, because of the light, but it's more of a kind of a mint color, and it is so squishy soft. And I'm not just saying that. I know lots of podcasters get on here and talk about, but this is some of the, I've actually never knit with cashmere and silk. So this is going to be one of the prizes for the Some Like It Hot KAL. So you guys, and as I receive more prizes, so if there's any makers out there that are watching this podcast and they would like to donate to that KAL, please feel free to get in contact with me. I would love to show your products off on the podcast. But yeah, as soon as I get other prizes, I will definitely be showing those to you guys. But yeah, I thought it'd be fun to do something to kind of celebrate summer, because it's coming up fast and furious here in June. And yeah, it's already in Texas. We got the heat index was over 100 degrees yesterday, and today it's kind of
humid.
It's humid.
Very
it's
humid.
Kind of cloudy and sunny. And we may get severe storms if the cap breaks today. We've had some really bad weather this year as far as thunderstorms. Yeah. If you've seen my Instagram account, you saw the hail that we had a couple of months ago. Was it a couple of months ago? It seemed like it was a couple of months ago.
We still haven't checked the roof yet.
So, yeah. So anyway, I just wanted to, tell you guys that. So next up is the winners of the 1,000 subscriber giveaway. So I gave away 3 prizes during the last podcast, and I've only had one winner contact me and for their third prize. So if you guys are watching this podcast and you commented on that thread, Please go back and check that episode to make sure and see if you are a winner. I'm going to keep the winners open, I'm going to keep the prizes until the next podcast. If I don't hear from you guys, the other two winners, I will redraw for the prizes for that that 1,000 subscriber giveaway, because I want the winner to be someone that actively watches the podcast. So, if you think that you may have won, or you haven't gone back to watch that episode, please do and contact me and give me your mailing address so I can get those prizes out to you. Otherwise, they will go to two other viewers. Okay. And last up, I showed you last week on the podcast, and it was actually going to be in my pick section. I was going to do a test knit for some pineapple socks for Wendy Geckner, but she actually already had enough test knitters for that, and so I don't have to test knit that for her, but it is going into my queue, and it is the pineapple socks, and I'm gonna see if I can show that to you. I should have had this already pulled up, but she is giving away, she is doing a discount on the pattern until June the 15th, and it's the code BBYY, and that pattern is only a dollar. Only a dollar. So you really can't beat that. I'll actually put a picture of it and insert it right here for you because I don't have it on my phone. But once again, that is the Pineapple Socks by Wendy Geckner, and it's just $1, and it is the code BBYY. Okay, so now I'm going to turn this podcast over to Jordan, because in the last podcast, Jordan came up with this brilliant idea to ask our viewers, where did knitting come from? And now he has the answer to the podcast.
Okay.
Hold on. I just
hear, I'll just hold on to it.
Alexis. Well, Alexis woke up from her nap, and as you can see, she's not really in that great of a mood. So we're about to wrap this up. So, Jordan?
Okay. So the answer to last week's question is, so the earliest recording of a knitting artifact was in 1100 BC in modern-day Egypt. So if you said anything like it came from Egypt, you are correct.
Yay! So that was a little bit of trivia for you guys. So Jordan now has the next question for the next podcast.
Me.
This.
No, Jordan has it.
This question is, when was yarn invented? Nice and simple.
Nice and simple. So when was yarn invented?
What year?
What year? What,
yeah.
What year?
Okay. What year?
Great. Okay, so I think that is it, Jordan. Alexis, you want to say hi? Say hi, Happee Knitters.
Hi, my Knitter.
Say what?
What?
Anyway, you know how toddlers are when they get up from their naps. They're kind of cranky. Are you cranky?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
A little bit. Yeah. Okay. So anyway, so guys, thank you so much for tuning in to this podcast. I know it was a little bit disjointed, but I appreciate you guys hanging with us. What are you doing, Lexi? You wanna sit with him? Okay. Okay. You wanna sit right there? You guys, when it comes to kids and their unpredictability.
He did this last time.
That's what they do. So until next time, guys.
Ooh.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
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 Bye.